Why do cells not make proteins with D-amino acids? Be it in a unicellular bacterium or a multicellular human, proteins are the workhorses of all living cells of every organism. There are millions of them in cells, and new ones are constantly being made using 20 different amino acids as their raw material in a process called protein translation. Something very special happens during this process. Cells contain two forms of amino acids called the chiral forms. They have the same chemical composition but are mirror images of each other. Only one of them, called the L-amino acids, are picked for making proteins. The D forms are never used. How do cells identify such a minute difference? It is known that different molecules of protein translation machinery bind to L-amino acids more easily. It starts with tRNA binding to an L-amino acid, which with help of other enzymes goes to ribosome, where there are other tRNA's amino acid complexes together to form a protein. But this is not foolproof. Sometimes tRNAs also attach D-amino acids. If this goes unnoticed and D-amino acids get added in proteins, it can hamper the cell's working or even kill it. So, every cell has a common way of preventing the problem. They have an enzyme called the D-aminoacyl tRNA deacylase, aka DTD, that selectively binds to D-amino acids and keeps them out of protein translation. Studies from Dr. Shankaranarayanan's lab at CSIR, Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology, detail how DTD functions. They show that DTD has a pocket that fits to D-amino acids linked to tRNA. Once inside this pocket, a chemical reaction chops the bond between the tRNA and amino acid. As a result, this amino acid cannot be used in protein translation. On the other hand, the L-amino acids bound to tRNA don't fit into the pocket and are thus spared. Not only amino acids, DTD also identifies tRNA. This is hallmark of an ancient enzyme, and DTD's presence across all life forms shows its importance and need across evolution. Together, it seems that, starting from early unicellular life, DTD has worked with cells' tRNA to reject D-amino acids when making proteins as a chirality filter, thus setting up a stage for proteins with L-amino acids in the vast living world to evolve later.